Roar! Or whatever.
Good evening, Dino fans. D-Rex here with another exciting toy review. Today we're going to look at the Jurassic World Off-Road Rescue Rig from Matchbox and Mattel. If we take a look at the packaging, we see the Jurassic World logo, as well as the erupting Mount Sibo. We have a Try Me illustration for the lights and sounds function. The artwork with Owen and Blue in the lower left-hand corner. And in the lower right, we have another action picture. The off-road rescue rig is supposed to work with your figures and dinosaurs, and also the deep dive submarine. If we look at the back of the package, we see another Jurassic World logo, as well as the blue background that we're used to. The action picture on the left says press for sound, and press and hold for a different sound. The action picture on the right shows that the rescue rig has lights, and also transports dinosaurs and works with figures. In the lower left-hand corner, we see a picture of the deep dive submarine. And on the bottom right, we see that it is for children over the age of 3. And something I haven't been mentioning much, there is a website for Jurassic World, and that is JurassicWorld.com. If you're looking for this toy in the store, you can see that its part number or item number is FNF42. That's F as in Frank, N as in Nancy, F as in Frank, 42. The assortment number is FMY60. To make it a little bit easier to open these, again, we have the perforated flap on the bottom. Push your thumb in where the arrow is on the box and pull out the perforated flap. Already, we see that we have a set of instructions and probably warranty information. And we see that the rescue rig has plastic lock washers on the bottom. Pull out on the plastic tab and rotate counterclockwise to loosen it from the box. Once you remove the plastic tabs, the rig lifts out of the package. Because the rescue rig is designed to work with your figures, the doors open and the metal cage on the back also opens. To keep this closed in the store, they've installed a rubber band around both tires and through the cab of the vehicle. All you do is remove the rubber band. Make sure you removed it completely, and the rescue rig is ready for play. I have a few notes for you. First of all, the doors do open, so you can put your figures inside. This cage open and closes, so you can put your dinos inside. And on the bottom, you can see we have a battery compartment, so you can replace the batteries when they run out. And it also has a switch. The center position is off, X is the Try Me mode, and the straight is the straight line is the on position. All the lights and sounds work in the Try Me mode, but I've switched my rig to on. The front of the rig looks like an armored vehicle, very much so. And you can see where the headlights are located. We have on the other side, we have another door that opens and closes. I don't know if you can see, but inside there's a clear tube with a spring in it. That's connected to the button mechanism. The actual button that activates the sounds is down here in the base of the truck, and this button is simply a way to make it easier for kids to push the button. I don't know much about military trucks, but this one looks certainly looks like a military truck to me, especially with the what looks like shatter-resistant glass. It has very nice lights and fog lights on top. Hopefully you can see the inside the cab. I've put Owen and Claire in it, and you can see that they fit quite comfortably. One note about the doors, they don't tend to close all the way, so make sure you give them a little bit of an extra push to seal the door. Okay, because this is a rescue rig, I want to compare it to some of the dinos. I have my Red Coles Raptor. It's the same size as the Attack Pack dinos. And you can see she does fit quite nicely in the trailer. I also have a battle damage figure. They are roughly all the same size. And you can see that she does fit inside the trailer, although the cage doesn't close all the way depending on how you have her positioned. Maybe she'd fit better this way. Simply because of the high spots on the figure, it's difficult to get these two pieces to meet up in the middle. But she is on there, and she does fit. Unfortunately for the Roarvore figures, you can put them on the trailer and haul them around, but you cannot close the cage and secure the dinosaur. So it looks like for Roarvores, at least, you're going to need a bigger truck. Just in case you thought it was the Triceratops' fault, I thought I would show you what the Allosaurus looks on the back of this truck. And again, doesn't fit very well. He's much too big. Even if we lay him down like that, you can't get the cage to close all of the way. The off-road rescue rig is also supposed to be able to transport the deep-dive submarine. And as you can see, it does in fact fit on the trailer. The illustrations and instructions show the submarine facing the back of the vehicle. As you can see, it will also haul it facing forward. And you can move the truck, and it doesn't fall off. And that's mainly because it's been secured by these air hoses from your ballast tanks. And here you see the submarine facing the back of the truck. Something I want to make note of for you, though, is the weight of the submarine keeps these back tires from spinning. So as you can see, they move a little, but they don't actually spin. They just sort of slide along the surface. That's due to the weight of this vehicle. Other than that, I would say it absolutely works as intended. If you've seen my Roarvores video, you know that I don't like to demonstrate toy sounds in videos because they never sound right. In this case, it's a major part of the toy, so I'm going to explain them first and then demonstrate them. You can see that it has headlights on the front. When you press the button and activate the sound, the lights come on. They turn off when the truck turns itself off. You can tap the button and it will start the truck. You can tap the button again, and it will make a louder, different engine noise, like you're putting it into gear. You can tap the button again, and it will sound the horn. Or you can hold the button, and it will produce a T-Rex roar. Now, as long as you keep pressing the button, the truck will stay on and continue making the engine noise and make whatever sound that you've activated. If you leave the truck sit and you don't press the button, eventually it does turn itself off. Here we go. And there you have it, Dino fans. That is the Lights and Sounds Off-Road Rescue Rig from the Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom line by Mattel. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please press the like button. It really does help me out. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more toy reviews and other videos. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.